Today I want to share with you 10 golden rules for your candlestick trading, and you're gonna need this before you trade with candlestick. We're gonna talk about that today, coming up next. So the first rule that you need to know when you trade candlestick is the location is very, very important. Just like when you buy property, people always talk about location, location, location is the same thing for candlestick pattern. In other words, don't just look at individual candlestick, you gotta look at the big picture. A lot of people say, Karen, how come I use candlestick but then it doesn't work out? I see a bullish army pattern, I see a bullish engulfing pattern, but when I buy, instead of the price going up, it goes the other way around. How come? Because way too many traders, they just look at individual candlestick. They don't look at the context of it. You're gonna understand this candlestick signal that you see right now. Where is it? Where does it appear? Does it appear on an uptrend? Okay, does it appear on a downtrend? Does it appear in a ranging market? Or does it appear in a volatile market? And not only that, does it appear at the start of the trend? Does it appear in the middle of the trend? Or does it appear at the end of the trend? Because all of these factors is going to determine whether the candlestick pattern is going to work out or not. Because if it appears at the wrong places, then it's not going to work out. The probability is going to be very low. Because certain candlesticks work better in an uptrend, certain candlesticks would work out only in a downtrend. So for example, if I'm to ask you one question, okay? Let's say if you trade doji, okay? If you trade doji, which one would be more effective? A doji that appears at a double bottom, okay, or a doji that appears right in the middle of the downtrend? Which one do you think is more effective? Which one do you think has a higher probability that the price is going to reverse? The one that appears at the second bottom of a double bottom, or the one that appears randomly right in the middle of the trend? You already know the answer. And if you watch my past candlestick videos, you also realize that I emphasize a lot on, okay, let's say this, the candlestick pattern can be anything, can be bullish army, can be all the patterns that I talk about, okay? You're gonna look at what appears, what is happening before this candlestick and what's happening after the candlestick. So for example, if you see the market do a 90 degree drop, okay, 90 degree drop, then followed by a bullish signal. Let's say for example, you see a bullish engulfing pattern. Okay, you see a bullish engulfing pattern right after this 90 degree drop. If you watched my previous video, you know that when the market does this kind of free fall, very likely that this is the end of the trend. And also what happens after? What happens after this can be many different things. This can be a second bottom, can be a third bottom. This can test a support zone. This can be followed by three bullish candle. Some people call it three white soldiers, which is a bullish signal. So all these increase your probability that the price is going to U-turn. This is not temporary market correction. This is a market reversal. This is the end of the trend. Then the second candlestick rule you need to know is don't use candlestick in isolation. Don't use it without confirmation, additional confirmation. Now, way too many people, they just rely on candlestick alone and that's it. If you want to increase your probability of making a profit, you gotta use at least one, okay, at least one more additional confirmation indicator. Now, there are many confirmation indicators that you can use depending on what you like, depending on which one you're more comfortable using. I'm just gonna give you a couple of options and then you choose from there, okay? So some of the confirmation indicators that you can use is, for example, you can confirm it using moving average, okay? Using a long-term moving average in particular. You can confirm it using trend lines. You can confirm it using support resistance. Basically, these two are technically dynamic support resistance. Some people use FIBO to confirm. Some people use RSI, MACD, Okay, the momentum indicators. Some people use indicators like stochastics. Some people use parabolic SAR. Let me know if you want me to do a video on stochastic or SAR. I've already done videos on RSI, MACD, all of these things. Feel free to go check it out. So a very common confirmation indicator that a lot of people like to use is, for example, moving average, okay? So let's say you are trading the buy market right now. Then the price comes down, okay? Does a temporary market correction, and then you see, let's say for example, a bullish Harami pattern, okay? And then it tests this long-term moving average, okay? It tests this long-term moving average. So a lot of people, they like to use 100 SMA or 200 SMA, depending on the time frame that you use. You know that moving average acts as a dynamic support resistance. In this case, it's a dynamic support. And with that said, a lot of people also use trend lines. So they draw another trend line, okay? Let's say the price tested this very strong trend line, and at the same time, price came down, test this trend line, at the same time it tests moving average. So this is like a double concrete floor that's really strong, that tells you that, okay, very likely the price is going to bounce up. Okay, then the next thing you gotta do is to learn the psychology behind wicks and the candle body. Now a lot of people say, Karen, it's very hard to memorize all the names of the different candlesticks. The good news is you don't need to memorize all those names. You just need to learn the psychology behind it. Are the buyers winning or are the buyers losing out? Are the sellers winning or are the sellers losing out? Because at the end of the day, it's still a tug of war between buyers and sellers. So for example, without considering the name, okay, if I show you this pattern, a red candlestick with a very, very long upper wick, but no lower wick, okay? So if you are seeing this in an hourly time frame, what happened is that the price opened right here, okay? And during this whole entire hour, the price went all the way up here, okay? Means buyers pushed the price up. But then along the way, the sellers start to come in and then be like, nope, I'm not gonna let you take control of this. Then they got pushed the price down, 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 and down, and down. And then eventually the price closed over here. This means that even though buyers were winning at first, but then at the end of the hour, who won? The sellers won. You have a red candle, you have a black candle. At the end of the hour, and this tells you that sellers might, okay, might, not guaranteed, but might continue to push the price downwards because at this point of time, sellers are winning. Now, if you really want to understand and know the names, which is very important, especially if you go to networking events and then meet traders, then somebody comes and asks you, did you see the hammer in the chart? And then you'll be like, no, dude, I'm not a carpenter. If you really want to understand the name so that you won't look too stupid, is to follow golden rule number 4. Craft your own cheat sheet, okay? Basically, you put all the patterns, everything into one piece of paper, and then you name it. And then you just write below, these are bullish signal, bearish signal, bullish, bearish. You know what I'm saying? Paste this beside your desk. You can look at it every single day. Better yet, paste it beside your bed so that you can dream about charts every single night. If you are a completely beginner trader, okay, you have never came across any of these names before, then a cheat sheet is going to help you a lot. So better yet, certain softwares, they will label the candlestick patterns for you. You just click on bullish Harami, then they'll put arrows and then label everything for you. That's a lot easier. So the fifth golden rule that you should consider is don't just rely on one time frame. Because you find that a lot of time, if you trade in a 1 hour time frame, you might see a strong bullish market. But if you switch to H4 time frame, it's a very strong bearish market. The bullish market that you see in H1 is just a temporary market correction in H4. So relying on another additional one more time frame is also a confirmation for you to increase the probability of you making money from that trade. Way too many traders, right, they just love to look at the small time frames because I don't know why, maybe it's exciting for them. They just look at a small picture. Like if you like to look at small things so much, buy a microscope. Because a lot of fund managers that I know, they focus a lot on the longer time frames because the short-term time frames are just too volatile. It's just random market noise. If you want to reduce your stress in trading, it is your obligation to move to the higher time frames. Even if you're a day trader, okay, you tend to look at H1 time frames, you like to look at H4 time frames, which is quite normal, okay? This doesn't mean that you should completely neglect the larger time frames. You also need to monitor the higher time frames, like daily time frames and also weekly time frames, so as to make sure that you're not trading against the trend, but you're trading along with the trend. But with that said, it's not compulsory for you to do this because it depends on you. It depends on how long you hold your trades for. Because if you hold your trades for only 1 hour, then there's not really a point for you to look at the long-term time frame. In fact, if you're holding for a couple of days, you don't really need to look at the small time frames. Large time frames are for you to look at big picture. Small time frames are for you to enter. Golden rule number 6. Do I have 4 more left? Oh my goodness. Golden rule number 6. Not all candlestick patterns work equally well, because there are certain patterns that work most of the time. There are certain candlestick patterns that's gonna work sometimes, but at the end of the day, it depends on the system that you use. Because I don't know what strategy you use, I don't know what indicator you use, so what I find effective, you might not find effective for your own system, because my system is different from your system. But with that said, I want to share with you a couple of patterns that I would say work pretty well in general. For example, doji pattern, if it appears at the right time, right location. And also, if you've watched my previous video, I talk about this one, evening star, okay? These are pretty effective patterns. Some people call it abandoned baby, you know, the names are just... At the end of the day, find one that is more effective to you, and most importantly, find one that you are comfortable with. So golden rule number 7, just like anything in life, length and size is very important. Just like when you buy a car, the size of a car is very important because it determines whether you can find a parking easily or not. Like I said, the size and length tells you different things. For example, if you see a candlestick with small body, okay? Small body with long wicks, what does this tell you? It tells you that people are indecisive. It's like you go to a buffet, you cannot make up your mind. When you see a large body, small wicks or no wicks, just like this one. Let's say for example, this one is a bullish candle. It tells you that the bullish strength is very strong, okay? The strength is very strong when there's a large body, small wick. And one very important tip you need to take note is that, let's say for example, like I said, this is a bullish candle. If the closing price is very, very near to the upper wick or upper shadow, okay? The nearer it is, the better, because this tells you that the bullish strength is very strong. The stronger the bullish strength is. And for bearish candle, you need to understand that the nearer the closing price is to the lower wick, the stronger the bearish signal is. So that's very important tip for you. And on the other hand, when you see a small body with small wicks or no wicks, this tells you that nobody's interested. You have a buffet restaurant, but nobody comes because your food sucks shit. On the other hand, when you see large body, long wicks, okay, large body, long wicks, this tell you that markets are volatile and then there's a lot of trading activity. So this is very common when there's a news event. Candlestick trading golden rule number 8. In order for you to trade candlesticks confidently, you need to build conviction into your trading system. This means that you got backtest, not only backtest, but you got backtest honestly, because way too many traders, when they backtest, they like to cheat themselves, and then they are going to generate a lot of winning trades for themselves. When in fact, the best way for you to backtest is to backtest in a worst case scenario. This means that every backtest trade that you make, you gotta assume that you're wrong. If you haven't watched my backtesting video on how to backtest properly, feel free to go check it out. But most importantly, you just need to understand that backtest is what makes profitable traders, because it is practice that builds champions. And as a trader, it is your obligation to practice like a champion. Golden rule number 9, you gotta take note of the color of the candlestick. Color is important, but also color can be also not important. Why do I say that? It's because it depends on the candlestick pattern that you're looking at. For example, if you're talking about spinning top, the color doesn't really matter. But if you're talking about bullish army, the color is the most important thing. Because if one of the candlestick's color is wrong, then it wouldn't be called bullish army to begin with, it would be something else. Final candlestick trading rule is use candlesticks for negative selection. What is negative selection? Now, a lot of people, they use candlesticks to enter, right? They use it to determine when they should buy and sell. But what a lot of people don't tell you is that candlestick can also be used to help you prevent getting into not so good trades, prevent you getting into bad trades. For example, let's say if you like to trade channels, when price comes down on the third point, okay, it's about to make the third touch. But if at this point in time, the candlestick patterns that generated here, there are no bullish candlestick patterns. Just a couple of random patterns appearing, there's no bullish signal, there's no bearish signal. At this point in time, when it tests this support line, then this tells you that, okay, you know what, maybe the reversal is not going to happen. So this would prevent you from getting into a bad trade. So then what do? You just wait. Just wait for the next time it comes back down and touch again. When it does produce a bullish signal, for example, a bullish army pattern, then you can enter right here. The key thing is, one bonus tip for you, patience is very important. You can learn all the golden trading rules all you want. You can learn all the candlestick pattern all you want. But if you cannot practice patience, nothing is going to help you. Even I can't help you. And most important, you got to have the strong discipline to not enter this trade when there's no signals for you. The hard part for most traders is preventing themselves from getting into a trade, because when I'm not trading today, I don't feel productive. I feel like I'm not doing anything. That's why most traders lose big time. They just can't wait. They just have to occupy themselves with an open trade. If you want to occupy yourself, there are many things that you can do, one of which is just go to a coffee shop. Now, if you haven't watched my candlestick pattern video, you have no idea what are candlestick patterns all about, you can check out this video that I've made where you can learn all the basics that you need, and hopefully it's gonna help you in your candlestick trading journey. So with that, I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye.